Dave O'Donoghue. I'm your Maryland Shakespeare Players treasurer, and I'm thrilled to be your MC for tonight. We're so excited for you all to be here, back in one person once again in the Ulrich Theater in Taos. Can we get a round of applause for Dr. Karen Nelson? Now, this room is already a story part of MDSP history. If this is your first review, welcome. Back in the ye old days before COVID, it was home to many an MDSP review, and I think even one or two shows. We're so glad to make a return to the space once again for this semester's review. We have an excellent program coming up with four scenes from the Shakespearean canon, entirely acted and directed by UMD students. A fantastic opportunity for three, yes, count them, three of you, lucky contestants, to join us on stage and show your mettle, as it were, winning a ghostly reward in return. We'll get to that later. It's Shakespeare Jeopardy. It'll be a great time. A raffle chock full of rat-tacular items and the renowned exec mad lib scene. I'd like to announce at the top of this review that this is also a fundraiser. Those interested in kicking us a few bucks can do so at @MD_Shakespeare on Venmo or using the donation box, which is over there, but will be outside at the end of the show. Let's see. All funds raised from this event will go towards costumes, sets, insurance, and other expenses for the upcoming Fall Main Stage show. Mark off insurance, I already bought that. But that's all to come later. As one final order of business, I would like to open this production with a little chant that we have here at MDSP. Before I say this, I must preface it. I can't confirm or deny that we are a cult, but that's why we're here there. So, if you know the words, say it along with me.
Rats! Rats, we're the rats. We pray that we stop tonight. We're the rats.
I'm the giant rat that makes all of the rules. Let's see what kind of trouble we can get ourselves into. So for now, sit back, relax, and enjoy our very first scene of the night. To start off, we have Timon of Athens, Act 1, Scene 1, starring Alex Brian Taff, Mia Cohen, Thomas Presovich, and Raffaella Taming. I'm also very excited to welcome the scene's director, Nathan Cavalier, to the stage. Let's give them all a hand.
Friends, rats, countrymen, welcome to the city of Athens. On this stage, you will see Scene 1, Act 1 of Timon of Athens, a Shakespearean tragedy. In this scene, the eccentric philosopher Apomantis levels a torrent of ridiculous insults against a group of craftsmen trying to fraud Timon, an Athenian nobleman, out of his mind. Prepare yourselves for insults, pettiness, and absurdity of Shakespearean proportions in Timon of Athens. Act 1, Scene 1.
Well, fair you gentlemen, give me your hand. We must ease that together.
Sir, your drool has suffered, I'm afraid.
Oh, what, my lord, dispraise?
A lord, say it to your commendations. If I should pay you for it, as 'tis extolled, it would unto me quite.
No, my lord, 'tis rated as those which sell would give, but you well know objects of like value, differing in their owners, are prized by their masters. Believe me, dear lord, you meant the jewel by wearing it.
Well, what?
No, my lord, he speaks with a common tongue which all men speak with.
Well, look who comes here, will you be chid?
Will fare with your lordship?
He'll spare none.
Good morrow to thee, gentle Apomantis.
Till I'm a gentle, stay that for thy tomorrow, when thou art Timon's dog, and these knaves are honest.
Why dost thou call them knaves? Thou knowest them not.
Are they not Athenians?
Yes.
Are they Redlocks? Do you know me, Apomantis?
Thou knowest I do. I call thee by thy name.
Thou art proud, Apomantis.
Of nothing so much that I am not like Timon.
Whither art going?
To knock out an honest Athenian's brains.
That is indeed thou shalt die for.
Right. Doing nothing, be death under the law.
How dost thou like this picture, Apomantis?
The best for the innocents.
What are your
Shakespeare Jeopardy, what am I talking about here? I mentioned a little ghostly prize earlier. We have a fantastic production of Hamlet coming up later in this set, and the one of you that wins the most points, I'll explain the points in just a second, will be able to appear as that ghost. We've got a little bed sheet with eyes headed to over there. So, if you'd like to step forward and observe this. So, in the style of Jeopardy, we have categories and numbers of points values. We decided to go with 1, 2, and 3 instead of hundreds, because we can't count that high, frankly. Our first category is Lit 100, where we delve into Shakespeare's work and its modern interpretations, heroes and villains, starring a veritable who's who of Shakespeare's greats, and Clip Quiz, a guessing game where you have to identify a play based on the brief scene performed by our very own Vice President, Raphael Tannenbaum, gives away.
Let's go live 100.
titular teenage heroine falls in love with a boy who comes from the family that first despises him.
Who is Juliet?
Who is Juliet?
Let's go clip quiz for two.
Yes, quiz for two. I'm afraid
what is
there we go. The Scottish play was the correct answer, and Maria got it. All right, fantastic. Well, we have one question left, and it's impossible to win. But let's see that last clip quiz, shall we? Let's do clip quiz for one.
Do you bite your thumb at us, sir?
I do bite my thumb, sir.
Do you bite your thumb at us, sir?
Alright, cool. That is really good.
Daughter's love. What dowry shall I have?
So this is the way I got that higher share with one or two people in this room, but Taming the Shrew is one of my favorite shows, not for its content, but because it has a really weird framing device. A framing device is when you like it's a story in a story situation, or you read a book that says that it's a book, that sort of thing. Lord of the Rings does that, for instance. It's like canonically a book that's translated into a different language by Tolkien. So Taming the Shrew, its weird thing is this. It has an entire first act, unrelated to everything else, where a drunk guy and a lord get together, and the lord tricks the drunk guy into thinking that he's the lord. It's like, hey, watch this play. And they never get back to that. So, technically speaking, it is the longest play within a play that Shakespeare ever did. So, you know, take that, anyway. That's kind of a hard sell. I mean, honestly, everyone cuts that. But you know what's not a hard sell? Very good transition. Our auction! Hello, welcome. So, we had 8 auction items, but now a surprise new entry has been added. Do we have it somewhere nearby? It's in the back, I guess? Could you grab it? So that pig painting brother who's coming back because we love it so much. So, to start our night off of the auction, here's how it's going to work. I'm going to tell you a little bit about an item. We're going to start bidding at $5, and then we're just going to call that out, and I sell it to you. Can you show off the pig painting very briefly? We'll get back to you. Hey! The only physical item tonight! So, to start us off, Nathan Cavalier, who directed Timon and Pumbaa back in summer. I'm getting into it a bit. Nathan, you offer to the buyer chooses a show, and Nathan will return a comedically sarcastic Shakespeare review of that show. So there we go, sarcastic Shakespeare review. Bidding starts at $5. Would anyone like to buy a Shakespeare review? Any show you like. Honestly, would you be willing to open this up to like non-Shakespeare plays and give a sarcastic review as if it was Shakespeare?
Oh, they trying to do Shakespearean language. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So
I'll be in Shakespearean language now. We'll add that permission.
Add that to it. Would have been like to start us off at $5. $5?
$5.
Do I see $10? Or $10? Fantastic. Do I see $15? $15?
$15!
Do I see $20? $20? $20? $20? $20? $20 going once, going twice. And so the ghost of Katie. Going once, going twice. So, Logan, you're now a squirrel. Phoenix 11 has our clown, the Dolphin, who is in absentia tonight, sadly, because of a event, but I believe you can go see their shows as well, is offering a custom throw pillow to one lucky buyer. It can be, let's see, the buyer may select the fabric and design piece will return a throw pillow fit to your specifications. So, you know, just go wild, my guy. $5, gonna start there. $5, do I see $10? $10, do I see $15? $15, do I see $20? $20, do I see $25? $25 for a throw pillow. $25, do I see $30 for a custom throw pillow? $25 going once. I see 30 in the back, do I see 35 for the custom throw pillow? Your choice of fabric and design. what did we get? 35 or 30?
30.
50? Cool. $30, going once, going twice, and oh, $35. Alright, $35 going once, going twice, and sold! What's your name?
Tom.
Oh, sorry. Sean, fantastic.
January 1st.
I would say, January 1st.
As well as a fun fact about that holiday. For example, today is National Metal Day. It started on 11-11-2011 because in celebration of the fact that in metal music, the speakers, you can turn the volume up to 11. That is why it's today.
All right, yeah. Okay, I see my dad turning into a reference there. Turn up to 11. All right, bidding on holiday fun facts for the rest of the year. Starting at $5. Do I see $5? Do I see $10? $10? Do I see $15? $15? Do I see $20? $20? $20? Do I see $25? $25? Do I see $30? Do I see $30? $25. $25 going once. Going twice.
Ah!
Is that $30? $30. $30 going once. Going twice. Sold! Okay. So I asked Katie, and this is what they said. Quote, they will design, Emma over here will design a font composed of sexy frogs, and write your name with that, question mark. Sure. So, Emma will design your name, but the letters will be sexy frogs.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's honestly pretty standard for us. Starting at $5. I saw so many people. Do I see $10? Who was this made by the way?
1, directed by Claire Riley, starring Grace Levine, Logan Ellen Hoover, Cameron Denning, Robin Morris, and our ghostly audience at War Machine.
Knows why the same strict and most observant watch, so that the toils God be toward, that this sweaty haste doth make the night joint laborer with the day? Who is that can inform me?
That can I. At least the whisper goes so. Our last king, whose image even but now appeared to us, was, as you know, by Fortin from Norway, thereto pricked on by a most emulate pride, dared to the combat, in which our valiant Hamlet, for so this side of the known world esteemed him, did slay this Fortin Grah, who by a sealed compact, well ratified in law and heraldry, did forfeit with his life all those his land which he stood to conquer. Now, sir, young Fortin Grah, of unimproved mettle hot and full, hath in the skirts of Norway, here and there, sharpened up a list of laws residents. For food and diet, this enterprise that I suffered, which is no other, as it doth well appear unto our state, but to recover of us by a strong hand and turns compulsatory those foresaid lands which his father lost. And this, I take it, is the main motive of our preparations, the source of this our watch, and the chief head of this post haste and rummage in the land.
I think it be, but even so, well, may sort this pretentious figure that comes armed for our watch, so much like the king that was and is the question of these wars.
A mode it is to trouble the mind's eye. In the most high and palmy state of Rome, a little ere the mightiest Julius fell, the grave stood tenantless, and the sheeted dead did swink and gibber in the Roman spirits, as stars with trains of fire and dews of blood, disasters in the sun and the moist star, upon whose influence Neptune's empire stands, was sick almost to doomsday with eclipse. And even the life we curse fierce events, as harbingers proceeding still the fates and prologue to the omen coming on, have heaven and earth together demonstrated against our climatures and countrymen. But so, oh, there it comes again! I'll cross it though it blast me. To thy country's
Zoe Gallagher as Juliet.
Upon thy face, thou wilt cringe backward.
starring Jamie Reed, Mia Cohen, written at Vornovia. There we go. Got a bad time. I really did. Robin Morris, Marion Gregorn, Thomas Breswich, Grace Levine, Logan Ellen Hoover, Zachary Thomas, and directed by Nathan Hollingsworth. Please welcome Nathan to the stage.
Ha, ha, ha.